Dear students, we are now going to see the next important temperate fruit, namely apple. Apple is botanically Malus pumila, belonging to the family Rosaceae, having a chromosome of 2n is equal to 34. It is the most important temperate fruit of northwestern Himalayan region. It is predominantly grown in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and hills of Uttarakhand, accounting for about 90% of the total production. Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Nilgiri Hills in Tamil Nadu also grow apple to certain extent. Regarding the climate and soil requirement of apple, most of the apple varieties require 1000 to 1500 hours of chilling below 7 degrees C during winter to break the dormancy. These conditions are available at an elevation of 1500 to 2700 meter above MSL in the Himalayan ranges. The optimal temperature for active growth period and pollen germination and fruit setting is 21 to 25 degree centigrade. Well distributed rainfall of 100 to 125 centimeter throughout the growing season is most favorable for its optimal growth and fruit setting. Loamy soils, rich in organic matter, having a pH of 5.5 to 6.5 with gentle to moderate slope, proper drainage and good aeration are most suitable for apple cultivation. Now we will see the varieties available in apple. There are more than 7500 known cultivars of apple, but in India alone 113 varieties of apple are grown. However, major commercial varieties are only 7. For example, Ambery Kashmir. Ambery Kashmir is the most popular and considered to be the indigenous production of apple in India, grown in Himalayan hills. Generally, this kind of apple is fully ripe in the month of October and stays fresh for a long period. Ambery apple is bluish red, slightly striped, medium in size and conical in shape. Next variety is American Trail. This kind of apple is small, round shaped and quite juicy. American Trail is very crispy and sweet in taste. The skin of the fruit is white greenish and sweet. This apple ripens in September. Next is Red Delicious. This is the most popular variety and it is a worldwide grown variety. It's also grown in Kashmir. Color of the skin is bluish red and the texture is smooth. Flesh of Red Delicious apple is greenish white and grind, sweet and juicy. This variety is available during mid-September. Next is Maharaji apple. Maharaji apple is a large sized apple with bright red color on a green base. It has some conspicuous dots. Skin of the fruit is crisp, juicy, aromatic, yet taste is bit acidic. This variety ripens in late October and it remains fresh for a long period of time and gets sweeter with time. Next is Hazrat Bali apple. This is a medium sized apple and its shapes may vary from round to slightly conical. Color of the fruit may differ from red color to stripe with a tender skin. Skin of this apple is sweet and juicy. This variety cannot be stored for a long period. It ripens during mid-July. Next variety is Golden Delicious apple. It is conical shaped, small and medium sized fruit, popularly known for its freshness and long shelf life period. It is crisp, white, juicy, thick, which is green in color and turns yellow on ripening. This variety ripens in late October and is available in the market till January. Apart from this, many season wise varieties, scab resistant varieties, hybrid varieties and low chilling varieties are also grown in India. In respect of the propagation methods, apple plants are propagated through vegetative propagation, namely whip and tongue grafting, chip grafting and tree budding. The scion collected from good bearing tree is grafted on to the rootstock during February, March. Now we will see how the rootstock is being produced. The rootstocks are produced from seedlings of crab apple or self-pollinating varieties having good seed viability, germination and seedling growth. Apple seeds need stratification in moist sand at 4 to 7 degrees C for 1000 to 1500 hours in 60 to 90 days. The water soaked seeds are placed between 2 to 3 centimeter thick layers of moist sand in wooden boxes or polythene bags during December. 1 year old stalks are ready for grafting during February. The rootstocks can be multiplied clonally through mound layering, that is stooling method. The rooted layers are separated at the onset of dormancy during December and transplanted into nursery beds for further grafting when scion varieties are available during February, March. The scion should be collected from the mother plants of known pedigree and from bearing trees only. 1 year old shoot growth is ideal for scion wood. The scion sticks should have only vegetative buds, not the reproductive buds. They should have 3 to 5 well developed buds with smooth internodes. These should be collected during dormancy. Scion wood is stored for 2 to 3 weeks at 5 degrees C. If the scions are to be stored for a long duration, say 1 to 3 months, they should be kept at about 0 degrees C to keep the buds dormant. Tongue grafting is the ideal one. Then the scion should be grafted 15 to 20 centimeter above the ground level. Tree budding during monsoon and chip budding during August can also be done for propagating apple. It takes nearly 1 year for raising grafted plants, whereas 2 in the case of petal plants. Now we will see planting and cropping systems in apple. Planting distance varies according to variety, vigor of the rootstock, fertility of the soil and climatic conditions. In flat and valley areas, the planting is done in square or hexagonal system of layout. However, on slopes, contour or terrace planting is preferred. The usual pit size is 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter without any hard pan or rock at its base or on the sides should be dug 1 month before planting. The topsoil and subsoil should be piled separately while digging. Topsoil must be filled first, followed by subsoil on the top to improve the fertility of lower layer of pit. While pit filling, 40 to 50 kg of farmyard manure and 500 gram of super phosphate should be mixed with the soil. An early planting of apple in December, January is desirable for proper establishment. Graft union should be kept 25 cm above the ground level to avoid collar rot and scion rooting. There are 4 density categories of planting, namely low density, that is less than 250 plants per hectare, moderate planting, that is 250 to 500 plants per hectare, high density planting, namely 500 to 1250 plants, and ultra high density planting, wherein 1250 plants per hectare are maintained. With the increase in planting density, the yield may increase, but beyond a threshold density, quality is deteriorated and may not be profitable in terms of economical returns. The major advantage of higher density planting are: 1. Potential of precocious pairing. 2. High yield potential per unit area. Low labor cost and better orchard management. Then improved fruit quality. Now we will see how aftercare is given to apple. Clean basin management is the common practice of floor management in apple. The basins are kept clean by hand working, hay mulching or black alkathin covering. Application of glyphosate at the rate of 800 ml per hectare or gramoxone, that is paraquat, 0.5% suppresses the weed growth for 4 to 5 months. In the initial years of plantations, green manuring crops like sunflower and beans may be cultivated between the basins to improve the soil texture and nutrient status of the soil. Heavy bearing in apple usually results in small sized, poor quality fruits and sets in alternate bearing cycle. Judicious fruit thinning at proper stage of fruit development not only regulates cropping but also fruit size and quality. A key to successful high density planting depends upon the control of tree size. Now we will see how training and pruning are important to apple cultivation. The plants are trained according to growth and habit and vigor of the rootstock. Training helps to establish a strong framework of scaffold limbs capable of supporting heavy yield with the quality fruits, regulate annual succession of crops, expose maximum leaf surface to the sun, direct growth of the trees so that various cultural operations like spraying, harvesting become economical. Also protect the trees from sunburn and promote yearly production. Training procedures for standard and dwarf plants differ. The standard trees are trained on modified central leader system. The ideal standard trees can be trained with 1. The plants are pruned to 50 to 60 centimeter above the ground at the time of planting. During first year, 2 to 3 well-spaced scaffold limbs are selected with the lowest at 30 centimeter above the ground and others spaced vertically 10 to 15 centimeter apart in a spiral fashion. The growth of unwanted shoots are stopped by pinching 2 to 5 centimeter of the shoot tips during mid-May. The selected primary scaffold during summer is headed back to 1/4 to 1/5 of the growth. During second year dormant pruning, the central leader and primary scaffold branches are headed back similar to first dormant pruning. More scaffold branches are retained on the trunk at the vertical distance of 45 to 75 centimeter. A total of 5 to 7 secondary branches per tree, usually 2 on each primary scaffold, are also selected in the second dormant pruning, which are directed partially outward. The primary scaffold should have the crotch angle of 45 degree with the trunk. The proper crotch angle can be developed by tying the branches with inserting the branches spreaders. Third year training consists of thinning out of unwanted branches and heading back others to desirable side limbs. Secondary branches often develop spurs during third growing season. By fourth year, training is largely completed. By this time, the proportional growth of central leader and side scaffold branches should be attained, which should be 1:1.5. This will help in lateral growth rather than upward growth of the plants, favorable for proper spur development. When the tree attains the height of 4 to 4.5 meter, the central leader should be headed back near to moderate side growing shoot to check the height of the plant. Dwarf plants are trained to spindle bush or slender spindle, that is 1 year old plant is headed back to 45 to 60 centimeter at the time of planting. During first summer, 2 to 3 laterals or feathers 30 centimeter from the base are selected to form main scaffold branches. The scaffold limbs should have wide angle and be well spaced around the stem. Vigorous growing laterals are tied down in August when the extension growth has ceased in order to develop wide crotch angle. During first winter, 2 to 3 well spaced laterals are retained and unwanted branches are removed. The scaffold branches are headed back to 1/3 to half of the length to a outward growing bud if the growth is weak. Otherwise, the main branches can be left unpruned. The leader is also cut back to more or less erect with a weak lateral. Any vigorous upright shoot growing near the forming leader and competing with it should be also removed. During August of second year, suitable laterals are tied down to form more scaffold branches. To check excessive vigor of central leader, it may again be cut back to suitably placed weak growing lateral, which is trained to take the place of the central leader. Delaying pruning until the late winter also helps in checking the vigor. During subsequent winters, branches are allowed to grow from the central leader at regular intervals, choosing wide angle shoots. Higher placed branches should be kept shorter than lower ones to allow the light penetration into the lower tree canopy to the maximum extent. The main branches should be also trained and spaced that there is plenty of room for fruiting laterals, and those should not be allowed to fork at terminal. In order to keep sufficient wood in the spindle bush while it is being built up, a small surplus of wide angled branches is retained, which may be cut when branches require more space and get crowded. Pruning in apple is essential to maintain a proper balance between vegetative growth and spur development. The basic steps of pruning standard bearing trees are: 1. Start pruning at the top of the trees and work downward. Cut upward growing limbs back to strong laterals. Then remove the crowding branches and thin out the remaining, leaving the vigorous fruiting wood well spaced along the length of limbs. Then remove the dead, broken and diseased wood. Remove parallel growing shoots causing crowding and shading and opposite growing shoots at a point on the stem. Remove all water sprouts except the occasional ones which may be needed to fill a vacant space in the canopy. While removing a thick branch, a first small cut should be made on the underside of the limb to avoid bark peeling. Divert branches to open areas by pruning to desirable laterals. Now we will see water, nutrient and weed management in apple. Regarding irrigation, apple requires uniform distribution of rainfall throughout the year or needs to be supplemented with irrigation during critical periods. The most critical period of water requirement in apple is from April to August, the peak requirement being after fruit set. In areas where irrigation is available, apple requires about 114 centimeter of water during the whole year, which can be scheduled in 15 to 20 irrigations. In critical summer months, the irrigations can be given at 7 to 10 days interval and the rest at 3 to 4 weeks interval. With the drip irrigation system, irrigation can be extended to scarce water sources area and hilly slopes also. About 1695 liters of water per tree is required during the season in drip irrigation compared with 3,840 liters per tree in the conventional method of irrigation. In drought prone and water scarce areas, the soil moisture can be retained by mulching or black alkathin covering immediately after spring rains. Application of manures and fertilizers starts right from planting. The first application should be made at the time of filling of pits. The fertilizer dose depends upon the soil fertility, type of soil, kind and age of the trees, cultural practices, climate and crop load. The dose of manures and fertilizers should be determined on the basis of soil and leaf analysis. In an orchard of optimal fertility, NPK may be applied in the ratio of 70, 35 and 70 gram of NPK per year of the age of the tree. The dose should be stabilized, that is 700, 350 and 700 gram of NPK respectively per tree after 10 years of the age. These applications may be supplemented with farmyard manure at the rate of 10 kg per year age of the tree with the maximum of 100 kg. Apple trees prefer NPK in the form of calcium ammonium nitrate, superphosphate and muriate of potash respectively. As the crop load is low in an off year, the standard fertilizer dose of NPK may be reduced to 500 gram, 250 gram and 400 gram respectively. Since the response to P application is poor in P rich acidic hilly soils, it should be a better practice if P is applied after every 2 to 3 years or should be reduced to half annually in such conditions. In bearing trees, farmyard manure along with P and K should be applied during December-January. Nitrogen is applied during February-March, 2 to 3 weeks before bud break. The nitrogen can be given in two split doses, first 2 to 3 weeks before the bud break and second one month after flowering, whereas irrigation facilities are available. The fertilizer should be broadcast in the tree basins 30 cm away from the tree trunk to the canopy drip line and mixed well in the soil. Deep cultivation to mix the fertilizer in soil should be avoided as this practice injures root system. Some of the important disorders in apple are, one is scald. It is one of the storage disorders in apple. Light mottling on greener surface of the fruits are initial symptoms of the scald. Darkening becomes more severe with elapsed time and ultimately extends to red surface also. Scald usually affects the skin, but only in severe cases it may extend to fruit flesh. Bitter pit is characterized by small sunken spots on the fruit surface, which are more prevalent in blossom end. Control atmospheric storage with higher temperature can be helpful to control this disorder. Appearance of the disorder is less at 1 degree centigrade in cold storage. Now we will see the insect pest attacking apple. One is San Jose scale. Second one is the white scale, which is Pseudolacus species. Third one is woolly apple aphid, Eriosoma lanigerum. Then blossom thrips, Thrips rufalandilensis. Planting of resistant rootstock, suitable intercultural operations, spraying with chloropyrifos, fenthrin, carbaryl, etc. have been found to be effective in controlling the pest. Now we will see the diseases attacking apple. First one is the collar rot caused by Phytophthora cactorium. Second one is apple scab, Penturia inequalis. Then sclerotia blight, which is caused by Sclerotium rahlsii. Then ground gall, which is caused by Agrobacterium. Then canker, dieback diseases are also very common. Planting of resistance varieties to the diseases should be used in this type of cultivation. The infected plant parts need to be destroyed. Application of carboxychloride, carbendazim, mangosep and other fungicides have been found to be effective in controlling this disease. In respect of the disorders, there are three distinct fruit drop is faced in apple cultivation. One is early drop resulting from unpollinated or unfertilized blossom. Second one is the June drop due to moisture stress or fruit competition. Third one is the pre-harvest fruit drop. The pre-harvest fruit drop can be controlled by spraying NAA at the rate of 10 ppm, that is 1 ml of Planofix dissolved in 4.5 liters of water about a week before the expected drop. Now we will see the maturity indices in harvest. Since apple is a climatic fruit, apple fruits usually do not attain fully ripe edible quality on the tree while harvesting. There are several maturity indices which can be adopted in proper fruit harvesting. DSS color of the fruit pulp, ease in separation of the fruit from the spur, change in crown surface, color from the green to pale, change in seed color to light brown, fruit firmness and days from full bloom to harvest are some of the maturity indices. Picking of immature fruits results in poor quality fruits lacking flavor and taste which shrivel during storage. Over nature fruits develop soft scaled and internal breakdown with poor shelf life. All the fruits do not mature evenly on the trees depending on the time and number of flower flushes. Thus, more than one picking are generally required. In respect of post harvest management, let us first see pre-cooling. After picking, the fruit should be placed in a cool and ventilated place to remove the field heat before packing. Air cooler, cold water sprinkling or fruit washing with water all helps quick removal of the field heat. Keeping fruits over height near the tree basins for cooling down is another practical way to remove the field heat. Fruit surface must be free of moisture before grading, wrapping or packing in cartons. Grading, now we will see. Apples are graded according to fruit size and fruit appearance or quality. On the basis of fruit size, apples are graded manually in 6 grades. On the basis of fruit color, shape and quality and appearance, apple fruits can be graded in 3 or more quality grades. These grades are designated as AAA, 2A and single A, or A, B, C grades, or extra fancy, fancy class 1 and fancy class 2, etc. For size grading, mechanical graders with washing and waxing facilities are available in India also. Packaging. Apples are packed in wooden boxes. Size of the wooden boxes used in different apple growing areas of India is different and carry about 10 kg or 20 kg of fruits in a box. Standardized wooden boxes are of 45.7 cm long, 30.5 cm wide, 25.4 cm, 27.5 cm and 30.5 cm in height according to size and grade. Corrugated fiber board, that is CFB cartons, are also available for packing apples. Such cartons are of two types, universal cartons and telescope tray pack cartons. The CFB cartons not only save the precious wood and forest wealth but result in very less fruit bruising, that is 3.5% only, which fetch good market price. The usual dimensions of CFP cartons with the trays are 50.4 cm into 30.3 cm into 28.2 cm outer jacket and 50 into 30 into 20 cm that is inner case. Now we will see the storage practices followed by apple. Apples have long storage life compared to other fruits. However, different varieties have different storability. Deterioration of fruit starts after climacteric stage. However, shelf life of apples can be prolonged by providing optimal storage conditions. The cold storage retards fruit deterioration and reduces decay from pathogens and shriveling from water loss. The recommended storage temperature for apple is about 0.8 degree to 1.8 degree centigrade above the average freezing point of most apple varieties. The relative humidity must be around 85% to 90% in cold storages. Most apple varieties can be stored for 4 to 8 months after harvesting. Ambry has the longest storage life among the varieties. So, while summing up, apple we have seen it is Malus pumila, a important temperate fruit of north western Himalayan region. The plant undergoes dormancy every year and the dormancy is broken down by natural exposure to below 7 degrees C for about 1500 hours. The optimal temperature of 21 to 25 degrees C with a rainfall of 100 to 125 centimeter throughout the growing and loam and soil with a pH of 5.2 to 6.5 are most suitable for apple cultivation. Major varieties of apple are Ambry, Kashmir, American Trail, Red Delicious, Maharaji Apple, Hasarpatli, Golden Delicious Apple. Apple is propagated mainly by whip and tongue grafting, tea butting or chip butting of the desirable scions and the rootstock seedlings grown from seeds. There are four density categories of planting: low density, moderate density, high density and ultra high density, wherein ultra high density accommodates more than 1250 plants per hectare. Apple is a climatic fruit and they are graded according to fruit size and fruit appearance or quality. These grades are designated as AAA, 2As or single A, or A, B and C, or extra fancy, fancy class 1 and fancy class 2 like this. In market we see fruits with labels which indicate the numbers. These numbers indicate the variety. Example 4015 indicates Red Delicious variety. For size grading, mechanical graders with washing and waxing facilities are available in India now. Apples have long storage life compared to other fruits. They can be stored at 0.8 degree to 1.8 degree C with relative humidity of 85 to 90% in cold storage. Most apple varieties can be stored for a period of 4 to 8 months after harvesting.